we coming to get our stuff, because the word tells me the kingdom of the Lord stuff is violent, and the violent take it by force. We coming to get what was taken away from us. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. The enemy can't have my stuff. Hallelujah. I'm coming to get it. I'm coming to get it. Yeah, hallelujah. 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 Just think about that thing. Love on him for a minute.
Yeah.
Just love on him for a minute. Yes, 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 yes. Yes.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of God. Whenever you've done all you know to do, you got to keep standing. Stand there for. The word says stand there for. Haven't done all to stand. Says stand there for. But you got to be girded up. Hallelujah. 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 We got to keep standing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. We're going to stand, God. We're going to stand firm. We're going to stand that for. Hallelujah.
What do you do
when you've done all you can and seem like it's never enough? Tell me, what do you say when friends turn away? You're all alone, all alone.
What do you do
when you're giving your all and seems like you can't make it through? Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. The gift of your past.
Yes.
Tell me, how do you deal with the shame? And how can you smile when your heart has been broken and filled with pain, what do you do?
What do you do?
When you've done all you can, and it seems like you can't make it through. Child, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. With the bondage again, you just stand
and endure.
God has a purpose. Yes, God has a plan. Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can and it seems like you can't make it through? Hey, shall you just
stand?
Stand,
stand,
Give him some praise. Come on, give him some praise. Come on, when you've done all you can do. Oh, Heavenly Father, first of all, God, we just want to tell you thank you for allowing us to gather once again, oh God. And God, we just want to tell you thank you for all of your manifold blessings. God, we just want to tell you thank you because if it had not been for your love and your kindness and your mercy, we wouldn't be here on today. But because you spared us, God, we just want to tell you thank you. Now, God, we ask you to continue to hide us behind the cross, oh God. Continue to cover us in your precious blood of Jesus Christ. And God, if you do these things, we're going to forever praise you. God, we ask you to do it all in your son Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen. While you're yet standing, if you would, if you get your Bibles, turn to the book of Philippians, the first chapter. Philippians, the first chapter. Philippians, the first chapter. And I'm going to read verse 20 and 21. Philippians, the first chapter. Verse 20 and 21. If you have it, say amen. Amen. If you don't have it yet, say wait a minute. All right, Philippians, the first chapter. Verse 20, 21, it reads as this. I'm going to read out the King James Version first. It says, according to my earnest expectation and my hope, that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but that with all boldness, as always, so now also Christ shall be magnified in my body, whether it be by life or by death. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless us with rightly divided word. Let it fall in the good ground. Let it bring forth a harvest in due season. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Now, the Amplified Bible brings to life a little bit. It reads, it is my own eager expectation and hope that looking forward to the future, I will not disgrace myself nor be ashamed in anything, but that with courage and the utmost freedom of speech, even now as always, Christ will be magnified and exalted in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me to live is Christ. He is the source of my joy, my reason to live. And to die is gain, for I will be with him in eternity. And the topic that the Lord gave me to speak to us for a little while on today is, I'm committed to Jesus Christ. If you would, look at the person and say, I'm committed to Jesus Christ. I'm going to say it one more time. Look at somebody else and say, I'm committed to Jesus Christ. Now, if you were really committed to him, give him a hand clap of praise. Now, the word committed, it means feeling dedicated or loyalty to a cause. Having made a pledge or a commitment to someone. Now, a lot of us are here today. We are married and or has been married, or you had a significant other in your life. And when they came into your life, you supposed to make a commitment. Now, if the truth be told, some of us, we just told them what we knew they wanted to hear so we can get what we wanted from them. But I'm trying to, see, we got a lot of children here, so I'm trying to keep it good. When you are making a commitment to someone, you're supposed to, first of all, you need to put God first. Now, if you put God first, you won't have to worry about doing things that are ungodly. Because, see, whenever you do something out of the will of God, You have a thing on the inside that's called the Holy Ghost. It will make you feel convicted. And you wouldn't get pleasure in doing things that would displease God. Now I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me back up just a little bit. First of all, I want to thank God for everybody that's here. I thank God for all of the elders. See, because this thing started to get good to me. Because, see, y'all know once the plane take off, it's gone. I thank God for the missionaries, the mothers, the deacons. Amen. Thank God for the elders. Amen. Y'all, let's give the elders a hand. Amen. All the deacons, I thank God for everybody in your respective place. All the missionaries, I thank God. I thank God for all of the visitors. Amen. And I just cannot overlook, amen, one person that's very, very important in my life. Amen. That make the church, amen. See, you getting ahead of me, because I know who you talking about, but I ain't talking about her yet. Amen. I thank God for the church secretary being with us on today. Amen. She make my life a lot easier. Amen. You know, sometimes I text her, and I be wondering if she got it or not, because sometimes she don't respond. But then when I get to the church, everything just laid out so beautiful, you know. And so we're going to work on that. Amen. Amen. She can just give me a thumbs up or something. Amen. Let me know, Pastor, yeah, I got you. Because that's what she always said when she said, Pastor, you know I got you. Yeah, but sometimes I need a thumbs up or something. Amen. That way I know that you got me. Hey, see, she said she got it. See, you had not caught your ass not. Amen. Now, Sister Had Not, I'm going to talk about the one you talking about. Amen. I thank God for this young lady that the Lord blessed us to have, what, 44? 45 years. Amen. We've been married 45 years. Amen. My high school sweetheart. Amen. I wouldn't have changed a thing about it. Amen. Because, see, I made a commitment to her. You know, now, sometime I may have went a little bit to the left, a little bit to the right. Amen. But, you know, through it all, we're still together. Amen. I'm just being real. Because we know it wasn't nobody but God. Amen. So I thank God for her on today. Amen. I love you, darling. All right, now we take the thumbtack out. All right, y'all aboard. Amen. The Lord say the same. I'm not going to be too long. Amen, because we have a lot we are trying to take care of today. Amen. But whenever you make a commitment, amen, seek God first. Because my Bible tells me it's best not to make a vow, than break it. Now, if somebody asks you to do something, if you're not quite sure you can fulfill that what they're asking you to do, just say, well, let me get back with you. That way they cannot accuse you of lying. Amen. But then sometimes you really have good intentions, but sometimes you just cannot fulfill what you said you were going to fulfill. What you do, you go to that person, you let them know. You don't dodge them and say, okay, I knew I said I was going to pay you back, but you know, when you see them coming, you take off down the other aisle at Walmart. Amen. And try to ease out to your car and get on down the road. Amen. Don't do that. Go to them and say, brother, sister, I know I said I was going to pay you such time, but look, this happened, that happened, but I will get it to you as soon as I can. Amen. Okay, y'all ain't like nobody owe y'all here. Amen. I know I got a whole lot of people owe me, but I don't worry about it because, see, I know that as long as I get my reward from God, amen, because you can't be God's giving no matter how hard you try. See, the more you give to him, the more he'll give back to you. Amen. Now, throughout the Bible, the Lord, he may not say that I'll make a commitment, but through the Bible, God said he will make a covenant. Amen. A covenant is an agreement. Same thing you can put a side by side as a commitment between two people. Now, in the Old Testament, God, he made, the first covenant he made was Adam. Amen. Y'all remember what he told Adam? He told him you can eat of every tree except for the tree of knowledge of good and evil. But he told him that the day you eat thereof, you will surely die. But I'm not going to go into all of the details. I hope most of you know what happened. But if you don't know, you need to come to Soul Food on Wednesday night. Amen. That way we can discuss the Bible. Now, the next covenant God made was with Noah. You remember when God, he destroyed the earth, but he told Noah that he'll never destroy the earth again by water. So what did he do? He made a rainbow. So, you know, anytime God does something, the devil try to duplicate it. See, now the devil got the rainbow talking about pride life. But then the next covenant God made was with Abraham. Y'all remember he told Abraham he would make his name great. Amen. Then the next covenant he made, it was with Moses. He told Moses that the Israelite was his chosen people. And don't you know when God have his hand on something, that don't you know the devil try to make havoc of it? When God let the people know that the Israelite was his chosen, then my Bible lets me know that there came a lad by the name of Joseph. We know the story about Joseph. Joseph, he was a man that he favored Joseph because he got Joseph at an old age. He got Joseph at a time where he thought that he couldn't have any more children. So he loved Joseph more than he loved his other brothers. And don't you know, a lot of the time when you show favoritism in your home, don't you know that will bring division between the other children? So that brought division in the house of Joseph. Then his father, I guess the straw that broke the camel back, his father gave Joseph a coat with many colors. And so the Bible lets me know that one day his brothers was out in the field, and while he was out in the field, they saw Joseph coming. But before they were out in the field, I remember that Joseph, he had a dream. And he told a dream to his brothers. And through the dream, the interpretation of the dream was that his brother was going to bow down to him. So the Bible lets me know, you can't tell everybody your dream. Whenever God reveals something to you, sometimes you got to leave it between you and God. Because there are a lot of dream killers out there. My Bible lets me know that once Joseph told his brothers a dream, and Joseph had to go out to the field where his brothers were, and the brother looked and said, here come that dreamer. I don't know about you all, but a lot of the times you may have people that hate on you. But sometimes you got to thank God for your hate, because, see, when people hate on you, they make you pray more. When you have people trying to destroy you, a lot of the time that'll make you draw closer to God. Sometimes there may not be people trying to destroy you. Sometimes you may have some health challenges that are trying to destroy you. And when you have different things going on in your life, that's a good time to get closer to God. Because I know my God to be a healer. Now, my Bible lets me know when they said, here come that dreamer, the brothers, they wanted to kill him. So that let me know that a lot of people out there, they will try to kill your dream, and sometimes they will try to kill you. But see, my Bible lets me know that whenever the devil's planning or plotting against you, God always have a ram in the bush. Amen. That's a place to give God a little thank you right there. I don't know about y'all, but I know there are a lot of times when God get me out of situations where I didn't know how I was going to get out. Now, see, here Joseph, his brother was plotting to kill him. But we thank God that Joseph had a brother by the name of Reuben. And his brother said, no, we're not going to kill him. What we're going to do, we're going to throw him in a pit. So he convinced his brother to spare his life. So what they did, they got a lamb. They killed a lamb, and they put the blood of the lamb on the coat. They went back and told his father that he was dead. But we thank God that there's sometime a ram in the bush for us. And while he was in the pit, my Bible lets me know that some traders came by, and they sold Joseph to those traders. And when they sold Joseph to the traders, my Bible lets me know he ended up in Potiphar's house. And while he was in Potiphar's house, Potiphar saw that the hand of God was upon him. I don't know about y'all, but see, when you got God in your life, it makes a difference. See, Joseph knew that God had given him that dream, and so Joseph had dedicated his life to let that dream come to fruition. And don't you know, anytime you're walking in God's purpose in your life, when you're walking trying to fulfill God's will in your life, don't you know that the devil will come and try to hinder whatever God is trying to do? But I'm here to tell you today, no matter what the devil try to do or what the devil send your way, what you got to do is continue to keep that vision in front of you. Even though it may not be coming to pass as fast as you think it should come to pass, what you got to do is just continue to hold on to God's unchanging hand. Here we see Joseph. He ended up in Potiphar's house, and Joseph found favor with Potiphar. So much favor that Potiphar told him that you can have anything in my kingdom, but anything, but don't fool with my wife. Because Potiphar knew that he had made a commitment with his wife. See, whenever you make a commitment with someone, you should try to fulfill that commitment to the best of your ability. But then, after a while, the wife looked on Joseph and she began to lust after Joseph. And don't you know that Joseph had made a commitment to God, and he knew that if he did anything with Potiphar's wife, that would displease God. So when the wife came and approached him and tried to seduce him, my Bible lets me know that Joseph, he took off his coat and he fled from her presence. So every now and then, it lets me know when sometimes your back may be against the wall, but God, he will always make a way for you to escape. I'm going to fast forward a little bit, but see, we see that Joseph, he was committed to God. No matter what happened in Joseph's life, Joseph had kept his eyes on God. We don't know everything that happened to Joseph's life, but we know that while Joseph ran, after he ran from Potiphar's wife, he ended up in jail. Because the wife, she lied on him and said he tried to seduce her. So that lets me know that everybody is not going to tell the truth about you. But what you got to do is hold on to God, even though they may be dragging your name through the mud. They may be calling you everything but a child of God. But what you got to do, you got to hold on to God. While Joseph was in prison, my Bible lets me know that Pharaoh had a dream. And while he had a dream, he went to his magician. He told him to tell me the dream and the interpretation of the dream. And they said, there's no way we can tell you the interpretation of the dream unless you tell us what the dream was. He told him, if you don't tell me the dream and interpretation of the dream, I'm going to kill all y'all. But then the word got to Joseph, and Joseph began to seek God. Even though he was in prison, he still kept the line open to his God. And after a while, God gave him the dream and the interpretation of the dream. He went to him and he let him know that you were going to have 7 prosperous years and you were going to have 7 years of famine. Then the king knew that that was a word from God, so he told Joseph, I want to put you in charge of everything. So that lets me know, no matter where you are, you continue to seek God. And while you're seeking God, God, sometimes you may be down low, but God can put you on high. God has a way he can turn your life around in just in an instant. And while Job was over everything, amen, don't you know that while Job was over everything, it happened just like God told him it was going to happen. There were 7 good years, and then there were 7 years of famine. And when the famine came, the Bible lets me know that the famine got so bad that his father and his brother had a need. And when they had a need, they had to go down to Egypt. And when they went down to Egypt, Joseph saw them, but they didn't know that it was Joseph. And when they saw, when Joseph saw with them, Joseph did some things, but I'm going to cut through the chase, but Joseph did some things. And after a while, Joseph's father had to come. And when Joseph's father came, don't you know, as the Bible was fulfilled, because his brother and his father, they bowed down to him. I want you to know today that no matter what's going on in your life, what you got to do is keep your commitment to God. The other second thing I want to talk about, you have to keep a commitment to your family. There are a lot of people, they try to put God first in everything. Amen. But then they'll forget about their family. Amen. But what you got to do, you got to have a balance in your life. When you have a balance in your life, what you got to do, you got to give God time, but you got to give your family time. Because, see, God bless you with your family. God bless you with your wife. Or God bless you with your husband. You got to learn how to appreciate each and every one of them. Amen. When I'm thinking about family, amen, I'm reminded of the prodigal son. Amen. The father, he loved his family. Amen. There was a time when the son came to his father. He said, Father, give me everything that belongs to me. And the father loved the son so much, he said, okay, son, I'm going to give you all of your inheritance. Amen. Don't you know sometimes when you get things and you're not prepared for it, you'll waste it. Amen. My Bible lets me know the prodigal son, he went out and he began to live a ruthless life. Amen. While he was living a worldly life, he was doing everything that the world was doing. I don't know about y'all, but I ain't been saved all my life. Amen. There was a time in my life when I was doing worldly things. But I'm here to tell you today, when you're doing worldly things, amen, you need to be like that prodigal son. Amen. The Bible say when he was down, amen, eating hog food. My Bible say he came to himself. Amen. Don't you know when he came to himself, he said, I'm going to go back to my father's house. He said, but I'm not worthy to be called his son. But I'm going to go back and be a servant. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but have you ever got so low when you felt like you wasn't worthy to be called God's son? But I'm here to tell you today, just like the prodigal son, father, he loved his son. No matter what his son had done, but his father loved didn't wax cold. Amen. My Bible lets me know one day the father was looking out. He looked afar and saw his son coming. And when he saw his son coming, he told them to go and prepare a fatted calf. He told them to go and put the ring back on his finger. He told them to go and put a robe back on his son. But don't you know that's all good. But anytime when you're doing the will of God, don't you know that a hater will arise? In this particular story, the prodigal son had a brother. And my brother was out in the field. He began to come toward the house. And he heard a lot of music. And he wondered what was going on at the house. And when he got a little closer, he came to a servant and he said, what's the meaning of all of this? They said, your brother, he was lost, but now he's found. So your father has prepared a feast for your brother. And he went to the father and he said, Father, what you mean by giving a feast for him? He done went and ruined all of the money. He done blew all the money. But I've been here with you all this time. And you hadn't prepared a fatted calf for me. Don't you know anytime you're doing the will of God, everybody's not going to appreciate it. But I'm here to tell you today, you keep on doing what God has told you to do. And don't worry what people say or what people don't say. What you worry about is pleasing God. And when you please God, you will get your reward. All you got to do is continue to do God's will. And he will reward you in due season. Amen. And the third thing and the final thing I'm going to talk about today, you need to be committed to the church. Amen. So first thing, you need to be committed to God. The second thing, you need to be committed to your family. And the final thing, you need to be committed to the church. See, anytime you love something, you'll give to it. See, the Bible teaches us we're supposed to pay our tithes. We're supposed to bring our tithe into the storehouse so there will be meat in God's house. See, anytime you love something, you don't mind giving to it. See, I don't know about y'all, but see, when I used to love my car, I didn't mind about paying people to wax it. Amen. See, but now since I love God, I don't mind about bringing the things into the storehouse. Amen. Because I know when I bring it to God's house, without having need, God will bless me in my house. Amen. We see that when you're committed to the church, my Bible lets me know that one particular occasion, Jesus went up to the disciples and he asked them, who do men say that I am? Amen. Disciples said, some said you are Jonah. Some said that you are Elijah. Amen. But then he said, who do you say that I am? Amen. They looked at Peter and Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And he said, flesh and blood have not revealed that to you. He said, but on this rock, I'm going to build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I don't know about y'all, but how many are standing on that rock? When you're standing on that solid rock, you don't have to worry about sinking. Amen. When you're standing on this rock, amen, I don't know what you might need in your life. Amen. But what you got to do is make it to the church. Sometimes your church might be in your closet. Amen. Sometimes the church might be kneeling on the side of your bed. I don't know where your church is, but anytime you have a need, you got to make sure you make it to the church. Amen. Because sometimes you might not can make it here to 6629 Highway 171, but you can make it to the church that's in your heart. Amen. But as the Bible lets me know that he said, on this rock, I'm going to build this church. And he said, flesh and blood had not revealed this to you. He said, my Father in heaven will reveal this to you. But then the Bible lets me know when Peter got the big head. Amen. But then when he got the big head, just a few scriptures later, you see Jesus had to rebuke Peter. Amen. So every now and then, we got to make sure we stay humble. Amen. You stay humble before the Lord and let the Lord elevate you. Amen. Because when God elevates you, you got to worry about man tearing you down. I don't know about y'all, but I want God to lift me up. Amen. I don't have to worry about what people will say or do. Amen. Here, now I'm going to wrap it up here. Amen. Because we have some things we need to take care of. Amen. But my Bible lets me know that way back in the day, amen, when Adam sinned against God, God was always trying to make a way for us to get back to God. Amen. But I'm here to tell you today that one day when God was looking around in heaven and he couldn't find nobody, amen, that was worthy to be sacrificed, amen, for our sins. Amen. Everybody had came a little short. Amen. But I'm reminded when he looked at Jesus, amen, when he looked at Jesus, he said, Father, I'll go and I'll redeem man back to you. Amen. But then God looked at Jesus and he said, what do I need to do? I need to prepare you a body. And he looked at a little girl named Mary. And my Bible lets me know Mary found favor with God. And after a while, don't you know Jesus was implanted in Mary's womb through the Holy Ghost, because Mary didn't know any man. Amen. But Jesus came and he lived among us. Amen. But he lived among us, but there was no sin found in him. I don't know about y'all, but every time I get to thinking about my God, I get to thinking about he paid a price that he didn't owe, because he knew we had a debt we couldn't pay. When Jesus came down and lived among us, amen, don't you know the Bible said there was no sin found in him? But then, don't you know, after a while, when that sacrifice time came, Jesus didn't mind giving up. Amen. Because he was already in glory with God. But he came down for glory and lived among us. Amen. While he was living here, he went around healing the sick. And while he was here, he went around giving sight to the blind. And while he was here, he went around unstopping deaf ears. And while he was here, he was casting out devils out of people. And while he was here, amen, he began to heal those that were sick. Amen. But my Bible lets me know, but then there came the time. He told his disciples he had to sacrifice his life. Amen. But the disciples didn't understand what he was saying. But when it came time for him to give up the sacrifice, my Bible lets me know that they brought him before Pilate. Amen. They took him from court to court. Amen. But the Bible lets me know that they beat him all night long. And while they beat him, they said he said not a mumbling word, because he had you and I in his vision. I don't know about y'all, but every time I think about God, every time I think about what he's done for me, I can't do nothing but get happy. Amen. When I think about how he was wounded for our transgression, he was bruised for our iniquities, but by his stripes we are healed. I don't know about you. I thank God for the healing power. My Bible lets me know that they took him and they crucified him. And when they crucified him, my Bible lets me know that the earth came so dark, because two suns can shine at one time. Amen. The S-U-N had to give up to the S-O-N. I don't know about y'all, but I thank God for the S-O-N. If you thank God for the S-O-N, let me hear you say yeah. Let me hear you say yeah. I thank God for the S-O-N. My Bible lets me know that they took him up to Calvary. And while he was on Calvary, they let me know that he hung high and they stretched him wide. And while he was hanging there, my Bible lets me know there were two malefactors on each side. Amen. There were one on the left and one on the right. Amen. The one, he looked at him, he said, You be the Christ, come down from there. And the other one looked at him and said, if you are the Christ, please forgive me. I'm paraphrasing. He said, please forgive me of my sin. And Jesus told him, today you shall be with me in paradise. I don't know about y'all, but I thank God for making a way for us to spend eternity with God. How many glad that he's made a way for you to get back to God? How many are glad he made a way for you to spend eternity with God? If you're glad about it, let me hear you say yeah. Let me hear you say yeah. Come on and don't fool me now. If you're really glad, let me hear you say yeah. I know he's all right. I feel my help. Here we see when Jesus was crucified. My Bible lets me know he hung there till he died. And when he died, my Bible lets me know there was a man by the name of Joseph. He came and got him. Amen. He put him in his tomb. Amen. While he was in the tomb, amen, he just wanted to be there for a little while. Amen. Because my Bible lets me know on that third day, he got up with all power in his hand. I don't know about y'all, but they let me know he got the victory over death. He got the victory over hell. And he got the victory over the grave. I don't know about y'all, but I can spend eternity with God. Amen. But that's why I read the scripture to our reading. Amen. To live is Christ and to die is gain. So either way it go, I'm going to be with Christ. How many want to be with Christ? Don't fool me now. Do you really want to see him? Do you really want to be with him? I don't know about y'all, but I'm going to do whatever I have to do. Amen. So I can spend eternity with Christ. Amen. We thank God for it. We thank God for him making a way. And see, once he got the victory, he let us know that he's going away to prepare a place to receive us. Because he said, where I am, there you may be also. He said, if it were not so, I would not have told you. But I go to my Father so I can receive you. Everybody stand for just a moment, if you can. There may be one here today that hadn't received Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Is there one today that hadn't received Jesus as your Lord and Savior? We would ask you to just raise your hand where you are. Is there one?
Amen. Thank you. Is there another? Is there another that hadn't seen Jesus as Lord and Savior? See, God already knows. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You can put your hand down. Is there another? If you feel the Lord is tugging on your heart right now, and if you want him to come into your life even right now, we're just going to ask you to come down to the altar. If you know you hadn't received him, if you want to receive him today, because tomorrow's not promised to any of us. Is there one today? All right. Is there one that need prayer today? Just raise your hand where you are. Amen. 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 Oh, amen. We thank God for all of you raising your hands. If it's all right today, I just want to pray for you right where you are. Normally, I would have you to come, but today, I just want to pray for right where you are. Everybody would just close your eyes. Oh, Heavenly Father, first of all, God, I just want to tell you, thank you for these, your people. First of all, God, I want to tell you, thank you for those that already made a commitment to you. And if God has anything in their life that causes them to not fulfill the purpose that you have for them, God, we ask you to reveal to them what it is and give them the power that they need so they can put you first, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Now, God, we ask you to look on all of those that raise a hand and say they need prayer on today. God, you know what they're standing in need of, even before we ask. And God, you know the desires of each and every one of our hearts. So God, we ask you to move as only you can in the name of Jesus. Bless as only you can. And God, if you do these things, we're going to forever praise you. God, we ask you to do it all in your son Jesus' name. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. And amen.